Here I am to discuss about one of the techniques of supportive psychotherapy, that is compassion and ventilation. This compassion and ventilation term, especially the term ventilation, is most widely used in psychoanalytic therapies, because in psychoanalytic therapy one can observe in the form of free association or during hypnosis or during the process of psychotherapy, psychoanalysts like Sigmund Freud, Carl Jung and so on stressed mainly on expressing whatever is there inside the person's or the client's mind freely. That kind of freeness was, or free atmosphere or time and space was provided for the clients to express themselves. So this compassion and ventilation is also being used as one of the techniques of supportive psychotherapy. Coming to the meaning of confession and ventilation. Confession is nothing but a statement admitting to some actions. For example, a person or the client who comes to the therapy, he or she must have done something in his past which now he or she is feeling that he should not have done that, or is regretful about. When he or she is regretting about the actions he did in the past and he has not told that he is the person who did that action, during the process of therapy with the therapist, one can tell or one can agree that he is the one who did that action, or he can admit his actions that he has done in the past. That is called as confession. And to confess, it requires a lot of mental strength for an individual, because that the confession or the actions which he or she is confessing now would have led to some major problem or trouble to others in the past, or to himself or herself. Coming to ventilation, the meaning of ventilation is nothing but expression of bottled up emotions which brings about a sense of relief in the client. So as the term itself says here, ventilation refers to expression of the stored emotions, the emotions or the feelings that the client has not told anyone till now. So that process is called as ventilation, and the end product of ventilation, after ventilating or after expressing the bottled up emotions, one is supposed to feel relieved. So that is the objective of ventilation. So this ventilation is also called as catharsis. Catharsis is a term used by Sigmund Freud a lot, and also he gave a lot of importance to catharsis. Catharsis is a Greek word which means cleansing or purifying. So here, when one person or the client shares his bottled up emotions or the conflicts that is going on in his mind since many days or so, it tends to purify his mind, or he feels a sense of cleanliness in his mind because he has put out all the thoughts that he had in his or her mind. So there are two essential components of this catharsis, that is emotional aspect and also cognitive aspect. Whatever the information that the person is putting out or ventilating in front of the therapist, it has got two objectives or two components. One is emotional and one is cognitive. The emotional aspect is that there is a strong emotional expression as well as processing, because in order to ventilate something that is bottled up in your mind or in a person's mind, it requires a strong emotional expression. Sometimes clients tend to cry in front of the therapist while expressing, or they need to know what they want to express. Is it essential? Is it important or significant to express in front of the therapist? Is it the real feeling that I am having in my mind? Is it the real fact, or really am I feeling this? That things need to be processed in one's own mind. Coming to the cognitive aspect, once the person expresses or once the person ventilates, he or she gets a kind of new insight or new realization about his own feelings, his own thoughts, because till then the things that were there inside his mind without being told or without being shared with anyone in his or her life, now that he has put it out, he knows exactly what he felt or how his thoughts are about those feelings. So basically, this catharsis results in a positive change in the individual's life, because now he knows exactly his true feelings, significant feelings or important feelings that he has put out in the form of catharsis in front of the client. So coming to the goals of confession and ventilation. As a supportive psychotherapy, confession and ventilation has its own goals. Means when it is used with a particular client, the goal could vary from when it is used with client B or client C. So the major goals of confession and ventilation are this. The first one is to realize the internal conflicts leading to disturbance in thoughts and behavior. That is, the person might be having a conflict which he has been holding in his mind for several years or several days or years for that matter. Probably the experience that he or she had during his childhood, and about that incident still the person could be having a conflict. Probably in cases like incident of sexual abuse or incidents of harassment or incidents of cheating that the person has experienced in his life from a major or significant person could lead to certain amount of conflicts, like conflicts in relation to trust, conflicts in relation to love or relationships, etc. So when a person confesses or ventilates his feelings about the incidents that has happened in the past, it leads to some amount of freeness or relief that the person experienced. So the second goal of confession and ventilation is to express the suppressed feelings and verbalize them in a safe environment. Probably the person would not have got a chance to express the feelings that he or she has due to doubts regarding the safe environment, trustworthy person, or the time and space that he had not got in order to express those feelings. So therapeutic setting seems to be a very safe environment, because the person who is listening to these feelings is the therapist who knows about the professionalism. So it is very safe for the client to express the suppressed feelings in this environment. And the third goal of confession and ventilation is to make the clients realize the positive effects of expression and verbalization, because a lot of times pent up emotions leads to stress, and that stress gets exhibited in several behavioral issues as well as physical symptoms. Sometimes it leads to some of the major psychopathological issues like somatoform disorder, or in fact stress which leads to schizophrenia is also very common. So there are a lot of positive effects of expression and verbalization, and this can be realized by the client because of confession and ventilation. So moving on to the advantages and disadvantages of confession and ventilation, there are many advantages of confession as well as ventilation. The first major advantage is to develop a more constructive attitude towards what one feels or his own fears or his own what he thinks as a shameful thought or so. By expressing, one gets to know that it is okay to have negative thoughts, negative feelings also, because of the reassurance provided by the therapist. And another advantage is that the person tends to release his pent up feelings or emotions and which leads to an objective reappraisal. Because when we think of the stressful experience or the feelings that we are having, we tend to be very subjective about that, whereas the therapist objectively evaluates those feelings and reassures the client. And the third advantage is that when a person or the client expresses this in a therapeutic setting, he or she tends to get a uncritical or sympathetic appraisal from the therapist. That is, the therapist tends to be empathetic as well as understand the client's feelings in a sympathetic manner also, which is very much necessary or essential sometimes. And another advantage is it helps, or confession and ventilation helps the person to restore mastery over his or her inner feelings. When you verbalize something, then you know what exactly you are feeling. It is its significance and importance, and you or the person tends to master his feelings or thoughts. And another advantage is it or confession and ventilation also helps in or encourages the person for self-examination or examining his or her thoughts and feelings. And lastly, this confession and ventilation helps the person to face past fears and conflicts, because a lot of times we do not talk because of the fear how we might feel after expressing that feeling. But then, because of confession and ventilation in a very safe environment, that is therapeutic setting, one gets that boldness, or one gets the courage to face his past fears as well as conflicts. Coming to the limitations of confession and ventilation, a lot of times not everything can be ventilated, not everything can be verbalized. We know what we are feeling, but then we cannot tell it or express it in front of others, which is a major limitation of confession and ventilation. And sometimes confession or ventilation might also result in amplification of the suffering. One might feel a lot of suffering after ventilating or during the process of confession or ventilation, because he has to undergo a lot of turmoil, or he might re-experience the incident once again. So not always and not with every client this confession and ventilation acts as a supportive psychotherapy, but then it has proven to be a major supportive psychotherapy throughout, which can be used with any other mainstream psychotherapy. And this is about confession and ventilation as a supportive psychotherapy. In the next videos, we will see many other supportive psychotherapies. Thank you.